So Ketch is basically application delivery framework for deploying your application to Kubernetes cluster without requiring any YAML files. Yes, you heard me right. So you don't have to write any YAML files and you can deploy your application to Kubernetes cluster just using the Ketch CLI. Let's see the architecture real quick. So you have the CLI, and then the CLI, when you create the pools and the apps, it will create the pool CRD, the app CRD, and the Ketch controller will be watching the pool CRD and the app CRD and create the required resources inside the Kubernetes cluster. Like the pool, it creates the namespace for the app, it will create the deployment pod, service, ingress, all those components of Kubernetes. Ketch, as of now, supports traffic and Istio, but they are planned to support more. So pools are basically, you can have one pool per application, or you can have a single pool for multiple applications. For different applications, you can provide different pools for different teams. And that's how it is. This is how the architecture looks like for traffic, application CRD, Ketch controller, and the ingress controller. So pretty much straightforward architecture. So let's get started. First step is to install the CLI. So CLI, I already have installed on my Mac. There's a simple command for that. Then you should be having a Kubernetes cluster. So for this particular demo, we have a K3S cluster, Civo K3S cluster. So we'll be using that. I already have a cluster created. And next step is we should be having ingress controller and the cert manager. So K3S comes by default with traffic. So if you see the install apps, we have traffic, and I already have installed cert manager as well. So if we go and see kubectl get pods, we should be seeing the cert manager pods running. And yes, the cert manager pods are up and running. Next that we need is to, so cert manager, if you don't have, so this is a simple command to install cert manager. And if you don't have traffic, or if you want to install Istio, then you can disable traffic from the installation by creating a cluster on Civo. Or if you're using any other cluster, then these are some of the commands that you can use for installing traffic or Istio as per the convenience. Then we have Ketch controller. So Ketch controller is required, and I don't think we already have. So let's install Ketch controller. So we have applied the Ketch controller YAML file, which will create some namespace, CRDs, and RBAC roles. Yes, it is doing the same. And the deployment as well. So kubectl get pods. And you can see in Ketch system namespace, it has created the Ketch controller. It's container creating, and it's running. We are done till here, and that's it. So you have downloaded the Ketch CLI, configured the cluster to use Ketch CLI, Ketch controller is there. So now is the time we create the pool and create the app and then deploy the app. So three steps are there. So first is, let's create the pool. For the pool, we add Ketch pool add dev. And for the ingress, we have to first find the IP for that. The external IP, so get svc, and then now what we'll do is we'll copy this. We already have this, so we need the external IP of traffic to be pasted over here, so that we'll be creating a pool dev. So dev will be the pool, and in service endpoint, external endpoint we have given, and ingress type is traffic, looks good. Let's see Ketch pool list. Yes, it's created kubectl get ns, and it created the Ketch dev namespace as well. Now what we'll do is we'll create app. So Ketch app create, let's say demo, and --- pool will be dev that we just created. So Ketch app list. The app is created, demo app in the pool dev, and it has also given an endpoint to us, but the units is zero, which means we haven't deployed anything over here yet. So now let's deploy the application. So for deployment, I'll use a separate image than the demo image. And we'll also use another interesting file, which is Ketch YAML. Just wanted to show you the customization. Ketch.yaml. Okay, let's see if this works. It says it's successfully deployed. Let's check that. Kubectl get pods. And it should create in Ketch dev namespace. Yes, it's container creating. And it should soon be in running state. In the meanwhile, we can check the other resources. Kubectl get ing. Yes, it's created the ingress. And kubectl, yes, it created the ingress, the pod, the deployment, all these things have been created. So what we'll do is we have to see, wait till the pod is running. Yes, the pod is up and running now. What we can do is Ketch app list. Now the unit should have changed to 1. Yes. And we should be able to see the application deployed on this URL. So let's just test it out if this works. Awesome. This works. Hello. So we have successfully deployed the application without writing a single YAML. There are other things which I just quickly want to show you, which is the first is the ketch.yaml file. Ketch.yaml file. So it's simple, basically Kubernetes processes and the ports. So when we want to actually, we have multiple ports and we want to specify a specific port that should be there while creating the service and the ingress so that it takes the correct port. So that's why we have specified the ketch.yaml file, which is good for customization. Next steps that we have is we also have something which is called, yeah, we have already seen this ketch.yaml file. There is also a proc file which you can use. You can add your own cnames as well. So it's simple, ketch cname add and to the application, which is demo. So let's do that. We already have a cname DNS name over here. Let's do a ketch add cname. And in the cname, let's add maybe Ketch into the app, which is demo. I think the command, let me just check the command. Ketch cname add. Okay. Now add cname, cname add. It works, and if now we see app list, it should list down 2 of the addresses, which it does, and this should also work. And yes, we can see the application works here as well. Next, quickly, let's see application export. So this is pretty interesting, and what we are going to do is you can actually deploy your application in a separate folder. So basically you can export the complete application as helm chart using the ketch app export command. So the command is pretty simple, ketch app export demo, and you give the directory. So if I go to this directory and do a ls, I will see the chart and the templates in where I will be having the deployment ingress services on 3 components. So you can have it, have it in GitHub repository or anywhere else. Now, next that we have is so Ketch we can use for application export, application deployment. You can add your cnames, you can customize your ports. So that's pretty much it about Ketch. You can also see the Ketch repository, and you can create issues over there and contribute back to it. It's open source project. And this is the blog that I have written, which explain all the steps that I have done just now for the demo. So you can try out this demo as well. So that's it for this video. Thank you for watching and subscribe for more videos like this.